Started now. Welcome, welcome to Mizoram University. I am Professor Bhartendu Singh from Department of Commerce, Mizoram University, and along with me, Professor NVR Jyoti Kumar, Head Department of Commerce, is here. We are holding a webinar on evolution of digital banking, the way forward. And our speaker for today's program is Mr. Amit Pandey. He is Senior Vice President in Kotak Mahindra Bank. He is a well-known person in the field of banking. But before his introduction, I would like to introduce a few other things. The way we are going to conduct this program, after the introduction to the speaker and the program, Mr. Amit Pandey will take over his presentation. He is going to use PPT with talk. So he will make presentation for the program. And meanwhile, if the participants are having any queries, any questions, please put these questions or queries in Q&A box. It is just below the screen, Q&A. Type your question, very precise way. Don't go for very long questions. Put it there. And at the end, after presentation is over, then we will take up questions from the Q&A section, and then Mr. Amit Pandey will be responding to all those questions. And after that, we will be finishing the program. Actually, we have scheduled two programs today from our department. First program is just about to start, already started now with Mr. Amit Kumar Pandey. And next program will be at 1:30, and a separate registration is there. Most of you must have already registered there. So we request you to participate, join again for that particular program. The title of presentation will be Quality Leadership for Future Business Organizations. And the speaker will be Mr. Shashikant Singh from DRDO. So we'll come back to our program, present program. Today, at the same time, another program is going on in our university, at orientation program. Starting today only, so our Vice Chancellor is busy with that program. So he sent his good wishes to all of us, and he told that he will be joining the program towards the end of the session. Meanwhile, we'll be starting this program. We have already conducted more than 100 webinars in last 2.5 months. Continuously, almost every day, we are conducting one or more programs. And every day, some new speaker from some new departments are there. Mizoram University was founded in 2001. Department of Commerce started in the year 2002. We are 7 faculty members with 3 professors, 2 associate professors, and 2 assistant professors. Now, if you allow me to go to our presenter today, Mr. Amit Kumar Pandey. He is a well-known person in the field of banking. He is having about 20 years of experience in banking. As of now, he is working in Kotak Mahindra for over 1.5 decades. But before joining Kotak Bank, he has worked in Tata Finance. He has worked in IDBI Bank, in Centurion Bank. And then he joined Kotak Mahindra. He is now Senior Vice President. He is a certified strategist from IIM Lucknow. He got his Master's MBA, Master in Business Administration in Finance. He is a certified MFI and IRDA professional and investment planner. He is presently heading West Zone for Working Capital Finance Business. His specialization is in the field of MSME finance on product and business development at Kotak Mahindra Bank. He is recipient of Best Area Manager and Regional Manager on Branch Banking Assignments at Mumbai. He got a special award on establishing Working Capital Finance Division at East and Central Zones. He is named as world-class leader in Kotak Bank in an HR survey conducted by Business India Group. With this small introduction to Mr. Pandey, I would like to request him to take the charge from here. He will be having a presentation, and after that, we'll be having a small question answer session. And again, I request to all participants, whatever questions or queries you are having, kindly put it in question Q&A box, not in chat. Go to Q&A. And all the participants who are logging in today will be getting a participation certificate by email. Certificates will be delivered to all of you, whoever joins this program. But it may take 2 days or maybe 3 days. So give us time for preparation of this. Now I would like to request Mr. Pandey to come up, sir.
Hi. Thanks for a nice introduction which you have given. I would like to start sharing my presentations. Hi. So good morning. Good morning, all of you. The important perspective of the today's discussion is digital banking. I think these are the hot topics. Before I start, I would love to have one question. I may be differing with Mr. Bhartendu about that, that the all questions should be asked at the end. I'm sorry, Mr. Bhartendu. I am open for all kind of questions in between, and I would love to have a discussion in the forum any point of time. If you think it is relevant at that point of time, you wish to have some queries and you want to hear. So before that, I want to start a simple questions with all of you. How many of you enjoys banking, and how many of you enjoy banking experience? Who has felt joyful or even satisfactory experience while performing any banking transactions or anything related to the bank? Especially in a comparative manner, when you do the transactions or you do enjoy these special services from various places. Well, silence speaks louder than the words. So nothing to worry, I have good news for you. The good news is that the banking industry is going on with the biggest revolutions of the financial history. The revolution is fintech revolutions, a digital innovation driver who will transfer banking as we know. We'll have winners and losers from this tech revolutions, but we know it is going to bring significant impact on financial sector. But those who are going to be impacted the most by revolutions are going to be who are working in the banking industry. The future banker will be very different than what it today. Different in terms of personality, different background, different skill set, different in all manner. The way you see today, it will be sophisticated, sensitive in all sense than what it is today. So what is this fintech and what is this all about fintech? Fintech short is financial technology. So financial technology means it is innovative use of technology into design, delivery of technical service, and it's transforming the banking. The design from things, the design from the perspective of innovations, the design from the perspective of the customer-centric manner, the design in the perspective of the compliance, design from the standardizations of the services which banks offer. Things like peer-to-peer funding, artificial intelligence, NLPs, robo-advisors, blockchain, cloud funding, digital payment, payment banks, APIs are just name of the field. The critical point is here is, what is this revolution now? And what is inevitable from? Historically, as the technology evolved, the banking industry was reasonably good to integrate the technology. In fact, it was one among the first movers that time, in order to better service customer, but all that changed during the financial crisis of 2008. During the financial crisis of 2008, banks were busy forming new rules, regulatory requirements, fines imposed on them worldwide, punishments as may case may deserve. But innovation becomes a very, very distant history, even in India and abroad. At the same time, some of the most game-changing technology evolutions happened. They had transformed the way we live, have become a part of everyone's life. That is where the change happens, on the field of banking service and the expectations. What happened there? There is a gap which was created between what banks were offering and what was as customer expect. That's the answer which comes as a silence from you. Especially user experience, communications, convenience, all other perspective. The gap is being filled by fintech and digital banking new revolutions. But the gap is so big that the non-traditional banking firms decided to enter, mainly technology firms. So did you know that the Facebook has 50 different licenses in US alone to allow vast range of services, including transferring of money by messenger? It has nothing to do with the present banking. Amazon recently experienced student loans on its platform, and the results are very, very encouraging. You may see n number of loans coming from these way in our near future. Alibaba, who's known for e-commerce worldwide, their financial arm at Financials had money market fund, which is third largest fund in the world, dislodging incumbent. Those were doing it from the decades. The USP on this fund, that this fund has more than 60 million single investors with average of less than $1,000 investments, with many of them as a first-time investors. Paytm enters into SIP plans, venturing onto book broking, investments and insurance, service the e-commerce platform. The examples are plenty and encouraging on the perspective of convenience and compliance together. WhatsApp offers the banking service in replacement of the chatbot. Policy Bazaar had changed the way of the insurance distributions and moving to change the loan and investment distributions without having a single branch across. It's a beginning, the regulatory framework. In the beginning of the regulatory framework for the apps and tech-based firms wasn't exist in various parts of the world, but since formation of Ministry of IT and Technology across the world, the regulations framework is introduced with opening up opportunity for innovators to enter into financial field without opening up the risk world. This has not only influenced and created a disruptions for financial institutions and banking industry, but a catalyst of financial inclusion objectives of a range of financial products to bring last mile persons into financial ecosystem and mainstreams. With presentations of smartphone users at every part, the penetrations of the world and India, financial service and banking are reaching to the tail end of the economic system. You know now well that the recharge works even at rural area, how it works, the fund transfers facility in rural, and how the transactions happens in the rural area through the smart mobile. In my presentation today, slides are selected from the academic perspective as the topic suggests, but would like to have open discussions of professional perspective and impacts in real world. Being a professional banker, would love to have open discussion in relations with the career opportunity perspective of young entrepreneurs, enterprising and thoughtful audience like you, with regards of the new upcoming and way to make yourself ready for the same. Presently, outsourcing call centers, frontline service staff, banks clerk, credit analyst, processors are being replaced with chatbot, virtual RMs, robo advisors, voice recognition systems, digilockers, also algorithm based analyst, etc. Internet of things are changing life, so as the professional ecosystems. Requirement of skill in the bank in future is changing. It is not going to be restricted up to the descriptions of the physical bank presence. It is going to impact on surrounding ecosystem too, like accounting firms, law firms, tax advisory firms, so on and so on. What is needed of, what is the need of hour? Is the fundamental change in mindset of start thinking beyond stable, monotonous jobs at banks. The industry is undergoing the change and evolutions with disruptions. Think to pursue of course of design thinking, a product development with core contents of the subject. As future is not going to open for traditional bankers, the future belongs to innovators, disruptors, out-of-the-box thinkers at large and strictly. Who is wish to have no rule kind of scenario during presentations? I am sorry and I apologize, Mr. Bhartendu, for the same. Feel free to ask questions and make it interactive at any point of time during the presentation also, especially if you wish to have more from this. If I can add value for forming or deciding of your way forward careers in the financial industry in your mind, it will be an honor to me. The new age advancement is exciting but vast. Can't be covered in hour-long discussions as it's going on to be started since the first step of the digital innovators. It may go on and on, require multiple sessions to form a strong base. If interested for the same, you can be in touch with me further also, considering my personal attachments with your university. Would like to have conclusion, discussions for opportunity and ways to build career or to start entrepreneurial options, startup options, ideas for fintech solutions in mind, if anything in going on in your mind for discussions. Repeating for benefit of questions and discussions are welcome. Repeating for the benefit. Again, questions and discussions are welcome at any point of time. Let me start with the basics of the presentations. So if we go back the banking industry, 1980s was the era when the computers has started changing the entire environment and ecosystems of the world. That's where the banking industry also started getting into the offering the best of the services. As I discussed just now, the disruption started from the
Mr. Pandey, one yes. Small
welcome.
Because of your request, we will take up some questions in between.
Great, sir. Thanks.
Yes. So, to the message to the participants, you will find an icon raise hand for asking question. So, if anyone is having any question, you can click on that raise hand and we will allow it to speak for that. But be very precise, very to the point questions. Don't go for very lengthy kind of things. And click on that icon only if you are having a question. So we are already having a question, so I'm allowing him to talk. Okay, Rajpal. Mr. Rajpal, please.
Mr. Rajpal.
Yes, sir. Mr. Rajpal. Unmute.
Okay, so I think let's move on. Once Mr. Rajpal is able to connect, we will be able to. I think the first question which is came is the digital banking safe. Yeah, there is nothing in the world is safe, but respectively, it is safe. It is much safer than COVID, and it is much safer than the walking into road, what you do every day basis. So the safety definitely is a perspective which is supposed to be addressed on day in day out basis in a continuous manner. What is safe today is not going to be safe tomorrow. That is how I see the digital banking going forward. So the digital journey started with the personal computer for the banking. Then it goes on the loan, local area network, core banking platforms in 1996. This is the place in the 1996 in India and 1994 outside India, which has changed the way, the perspective of the accuracy, which was the core of the banking. The banking has changed from only from the accuracy to speed with the accuracy. This is how the evolution had started. Then this one, everybody knows that the branch banking has changed from the bank banking. And then the biggest thing which exists today, it's anywhere and anytime. How does it started? So today also people are doing some transaction with checks. The checks are getting processed with the microcode. This is the mother of today's QR code. This is where everything started in the banking industry, where the coding has made it easy for accuracy and for the transparency of the transactions. This is the first time when language has changed into the codes, and the codes has changed into the language over a period of time again. This is how, if we really look into the progress, the banking is not defined in the phase one, phase two, or generation one, generation two kind of scenario. The banking has designed, if you really see before 1980, there are less to discuss right now. But in 19, if I distribute it in 10 years or decade era basis, the first thing which started is a MICA, which was the mother to start thinking about the digital process, in coding process. That's how we started. We moved from normal one branch banking experience to bank experience with the computerizations, electronic fund transfers, and so on. The branch connectivity has changed the entire era and thought process of the bankers, and the digital first footprint has started. The biggest add-on from the RBI was given was IMPS, RTGS, NEFT, a transaction mechanism which can enable you to do movement of the money in fractions of second. Then came to the era when you started discussing about customer experiences. Anytime and everywhere, in a real sense, without having a spending more time and efforts by individuals. That is where the entire things have changed. If you see the growth, it is a movement from necessity to invention. That is how the digital banking evolved. Product-centric to customer experience-centric, not only up to the customer center. It has moved from that era where we used to create a product for the benefit of the individuals. Then now we create the experience for the benefit of the individuals. If you see the banking industry, this is unique in terms of the evolutions. Most of the time, if you go and see in the technology side, in telecom per se, today nobody knows what is 2G, and they don't use what is 2G, about 2G or 1G. It is the time to think about 5G and forget about 5G, 3G. But in banking, it doesn't go like this. Today, MICA exists. Today, land computer exists. Core banking exists. And these all are a basics of the banking today, when we are evolving from normal online mobile banking or kind of other channel to concluding combinations of channels into one app with the omni-channel banking, one login, one transactions, one interface, or kind of scenario. What is the digital process evolution? How we will start? Technically, the today's scenario, the today's look and feel was started in 1998 to 2000, when the first time ICICI Bank has introduced online banking and e-banking transaction in India. Post that, everything is history. There is no bank presently sitting which doesn't have an online or e-banking facility. There are large number of cooperative banks are also started participating in banking through this channel. Then the era two was sharing the data. When everything started getting, the technology industry has started discussing about data, migrations of data, data analysts, AI, and so on and so on, machine intelligence. That is where the multi-channel integration started. From app to non-app, the banking experience has changed. Now from the app to non-app and multiple channels, which is required logging codes for entering so many channels, the time has came for a channel which can give you access of all. Today in your mobile banking, your mobile, you access the online banking, you would access the mobile banking, you access the QR code based transactions, you access everything from that channel only. One app can give you all facility, be it as investment, insurance, loans, banking transactions, or anything, whatever you think so possible. Then the era is where present is from 2015 onwards. And today it is highly mature, where the Internet of Things are changing the complete customer experience in the banking industry. What are the tools, what are the things which is there in the banking industry? Today, if I was wish to have, what are the perspectives which we have to discuss about this, about that, how will you access the digital banking? I think these are the 12 broader parameters, which is looking like that, which can summarize the perspective of the digital banking. Okay, so there's a question before getting into that. The good questions came from the first discussion. Do you think that the loss of the job from Mr. Sarthak? I think I didn't agree with this. Logically, the job is not dependent on doing only farming in India. The job is dependent that how well you upgrade yourself in terms of the skill required for the future world. The job is changing the type. The job is not getting abolished or vanish. The type of job which you used to do in the banking required an upgrade, required an refreshments on the way we thought. That is how the jobs will be changed. The banking industry looks like will be going to be a big job provider for sure. The other question is that how bank could help people for overcome such problems. Increasing demand of digital banking, it minimizes the amount of employer. I think this is how I have given you this, that I don't think so the demand of the job will be lesser. It is going to be the change of the perspective in the terms of job. What is debit card and credit card? The debit card and credit card is more about the transactions from the bank, which is going to be used on a physical footprint basis. This is the first innovations in the digital banking environment, and that is how the and that it is as I told you that in the banking it is not like the era is going and the transaction and the equipments and the instrument is going. It is all about that it is still exists, its utility is still exists. The benefit of that particular instrument is still exist. RTGS NEFT. So full form is real-time gross settlements and national electronic fund transfers. These are the way to do the transactions from various channels. The genesis of the all kind of channels working for transactions routing from one end to other end is RTGS NEFT. Basic platforms. RTGS stands for 2 lakh and above transactions. NEFT stands for the transactions of from 5 rupees to any amounts. Then the new era came, which is immediate payment services, IMPS. The need of our was to run the payment across the cycle. RTGS, NEFT has the limitations of the timing. And the limitation of timing is removed from IMPS basis. The need for IMPS is basis on the retail institutions and retail demands. Hence, it is not till now implemented for a large value transactions. It is available for small value transactions up to 1 lakh rupees. You can use your mobile to transfer anybody's account any point of time through instant mobile payment services. Then the latest and the most widely accepted things which came is the unified payment interface, UPI. Unified payment interface and Bharat interface for money is launched by government was an important milestone, not just for the banking system, but for the entire country for innovation perspective. The popularity of digital payments are resulting the great digital banking transactions. This is the most popular way of doing transactions cashless on a small, on a very small ticket size basis and day-to-day routine transactions, which we used to do through cash. It is changing the entire cash economy and converting the cash economy into a digital economy at large. Then it comes to unstructured supplementary service data. Suitable for future features phones without internet. UPI needs an internet connections. unstructured supplementary service data does not require any internet connections. So you can go, so for an example, dial *99# type bank name, and when the interface opens, enter 3 and tap send now, and the beneficiary mobile number. On the beneficiary mobile number, if you have MMIDs, if you have, so this you have to do with the places where you do not have an internet access. The utility of USSDs are going down with the evolutions of the internet systems. Remaining parameters like e-wallet, biometrics, NLPs, artificial intelligence, rope chatbots, or virtual RM will pay DigiLockers are very, very vast and relevant topic right now, which I would love to have a discussion in details. Let's start with the NLP. What is this NLP is all about? NLP stands for Natural Language Processing. Technically, it has nothing to do with the banking. But this is the process, and technological evolutions has changed the entire banking, the way the banks think, the way the banks operate, the way they behave today. Is one of the genesis is NLP with the artificial intelligence. So what is NLP is doing? NLP is transferring your voice, your language, your mind into a code which computer understands and giving you the answers into the language the way you understand, whether it is mathematics, whether it is English, Hindi, or whatsoever you understand it. This is not a one software. This is a combination of softwares, artificial intelligence activities. This is the way the chat solution has been given a reality for banking structures. So today your bank is not depending only on your one person or manual interventions in this. This has changed the entire scenario from the perspective of standard delivery, perspective of the standard answers, relative, and accurate services. Artificial intelligence is okay. Before moving out, sir, what is exactly is HVC? HVC is high value clearing. It used to be used for the purpose of transacting high value transactions which were more relevant for the enterprises on a single day basis, and this used to help for the for mobilizations of high value funds faster. Most of the things in the digital banking side, if you see, is basis on the small value transactions. High value transactions are handled with the HVC, NEFT. That is the way this is getting segregated on that. Okay, so somebody is discussing about steps in keeping OTP, hacking, and digital banking transactions. What steps can you advise for avoiding hacking? I would love to have a discussion on the regulations and the constraint on these particular things at the tail end of this presentations, and would love to answer your thing. Of course, yes, the bank manager, the branches, everybody working in the banking industry has a great impact because of the digital evolutions. And the things which you used to think about, to share with them. So let's move to artificial intelligence enabled chatbot. What is it all about? These chatbots are working for giving you experience without a manual interventions. What you used to expect from a bank, that it has to be available for you in 24/7 perspective. But for what? For transactions or for discussions? Chatbot allows you for discussions, understanding your query, understanding your problems, concerns, and a real-time accurate answers for that. This used to be a manual things which used to be there is a call centers, which were having a very high level of constraint, a human constraint for understanding of various aspects, constraints of people being present in the office, constraint to create a seamless standard processes. These chatbots are output of NLPs, where you write in Hindi, English, or Mizoram, or whatever you think so, in the language. And the front guy, who's actually a virtual person, is understanding your questions in totality, able to give you answers in fractions of seconds, going through with the all details related to your account, related to the banking policy, related to your utilities, whatever you're looking for. This is widely supported by AI and data management, data analytics, machine thinking. So this is very, very widely used. Now people hate to call and wait for 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 for a contact center representative to connect you. After hearing all your options, you are being transferred to the contact center, and then the contact center executive transfers you to someone else because he is not able to understand your requirement in total. All those error is lost. You go in your account, you log in an account by mobile, internet, or by any means, whatever you are using for, and there is a virtual manager who's there to assist you in your query without asking you n number of questions from his end. The question is yours, answer comes from the list. Kotak Mahindra Bank has the pioneer into launching this, the first banking voice board in Indian bank. The banking is not only depending on the write or chat basis, it is going on a discussion also. So how machine thinkings are changing the world? It is the change that they are removing so many human interventions from so many industries. The same is happening to the bankers. The bankers are going through with the change that the human interactions are getting converted into machine interactions. This provides you the best and accurate services, the best and possible, best and environment by the possible solutions for your queries, as same as the RM which you used to. The biggest thing which was asked from the physical network was to have the RMs, have a customer service oriented service staff who is going to service, who will understand your feelings, who will understand you in totality the way you want to be perceived as. This was not possible until unless there is a machine thinking can be introduced in banking. If you know, if you have seen Alexa and all other formats of which is a general assistance for your day-to-day job, the virtual RM is going to take place the similar manner. You walk into place, you are into your city abroad or wherever you are at home, you are in office or wherever it is. This assistance will follow you and follow your guidance in totality. It is not only going to be guidance, it is going to create an intelligent solutions for your needs on investments or fund requirements, managing your bills or so on, so many things. In one instructions, you can create multiple tasks on these kind of channels. And this is going to take care of the new phase of banking. This most of the people knows is the pay bills online. Bharat Pay is the most famous and well-known service provider for the payment of bills. This has transformed the entire systems of collections of money and rotations of the money from one end to another. For a common man, it is very simple and user-friendly interface, which gives him the facility to organize his bills. For MSME, for corporates, for all other firms, this features, which is integrated from the features of the cash management solutions, is providing the facility to ensure the collections are getting seamlessly recognized, reconciled at back end without having a human intervention. When you see this from the front end, it is a simple solution for you to pay your gas bill, to pay your DTH, to pay your other licenses or taxes or so many and so on. For a customer user and user experience perspective, the front end is very simple and very attractive. That's how the bill pay is widely accepted. Today, you can see that the gas and electricity distribution firms has reduced their bill collection centers to the 25% of the original capacities in 90s and 2000s. This has the power to move funds from one end to other end with the high level of recognizations for reconciliations and giving the benefit for the distribution electricity firm to recognize each and every bill in fractions of seconds for the payment, and they can use these payments on real-time basis, which used to take at least 3 to 5 hours of gap, and the fund utilizations gap was created, which was creating an opportunity for the bankers to lend. But today, it is reducing and creating a self-reliance for MSME, SME, and so on. Till now, we have discussed so many things on basis of your login, passwords, or so on basis. Now, the users are expecting us to move on from the basics of technological base, login base, or kind of instrument base like debit card, credit card, physical things to carry in your pocket, and dependence on that. With Aadhaar, the intelligence has been introduced for recognizing you biometrically. This is widely accepted for ATM transactions, for POS transactions, purchase transactions, bill pay transactions. ATMs are converted into as same as the normal bank. If you are walking into that ATM, you are enjoying all the services which you want to do it from the bank through your fingerprint itself. The new innovation which is coming is on the eyeball recognition basis, which might be helping for a person to not even touch for anything for the requirement of the payment or for requirement of the collections or anything which is related to the bank. Till now, what we have discussed is about transactions, about your user-friendly interventions related to your money. The transactions and money is the one part of the bank. The rotations of the money, transactions of the money, collections of money, deposits is one part of the bank. It is called liability of the bank. The other part of the bank is providing services for various aspects. The third largest part is providing assistance, financial assistance for various kind of need which you have. DigiLocker is the place which has revolutions in terms of the way you think about the agreements, the way you think about the certifications. This is widely used for all, even for your university. You create digital certificates, digital lockers has been used for that. A cloud place is allotted to you in a digital locker manner, which will be used by you and by the assigned person, only dedicated for that particular services. This is not ending up the security locker, the way you used to keep your jewelry, the way you used to keep your other stuffs of property papers and other things in the banking locker. That replaces that for sure. But in addition to that, it actually gives you e-sign, digi-sign, or so and so on things for acceptance of agreement and offers, which has changed the banking industry in total. The banking industry is now no more dependent on your physical presence, all borrowers, all bankers to sign at one place and then to process. For that, the interaction was must. It is now abolished. The interaction is not mandatory. The initial things. So this is initially, this was considered as a simple deposit keeper or a locker with a guard. But now the use of this is going beyond this. The entire system of digital lending is depending on the digital locker system introduced by Aadhaar. So how does this help? How does this help for end-to-end digital loan process? The end-to-end lending is depending on the digital locker offers. the activity which used to take at least 15 to 30 days time for bankers to perform is being performed at the frictions of seconds. In the frictions of seconds, you know what is supposed to happen for my application, how bank will behave for the requirement of money which I have. I'm sorry, I'll take a few more questions also. Some disturbance. Okay. Okay. So before I get into our lending, people ask the questions about that. Is there any possibility कि कुछ बैंकों द्वारा ऑनलाइन खाता खोला जा रहा है, जब ग्राहक द्वारा संबंधित किसी समस्या निवेदन ब्रांच से संपर्क किया जाता है तो उन्हें बोला जाता है कि ऑनलाइन खातों में हमें कोई मदद नहीं कर सकते। आई थिंक दैट इज नॉट द पर्सपेक्टिव ऑफ द ऑनलाइन अकाउंट्स, दैट कैन बी अ लैक्यूना ऑफ द ह्यूमन इंटरवेंशंस रिलेटेड टू दिस, बट द एंटायर सिस्टम इज सो ट्रांसपेरेंट दैट एट ब्रांच आई कैन एक्सेस द ऑल द डिटेल्स व्हिच यू आर लुकिंग फ्रॉम योर डिजिटल प्लेटफॉर्म। आई हैव अ फुल एक्सेस. Obviously, it is secured and given to respective employees for giving you this kind of services. Okay, does NLP has restrictions to in any sectors of banking? NLP has no restrictions. Yes, the till now innovations are actually restricted for the utilizations of the NLPs, where the NLPs are can be used and the innovations are going on. It is not restricted with anything. Presently, even if you go with the lending perspective also, NLP innovations are going on to use, instead of only a click base, till now whatever is happening is click base. NLP is being tested and examined for use of the human intervention through in the manner of the language basis. Okay, so Akshara is wanting to know, lot digital device these days, sir. People in rural areas do not have the good internet access. So how to deal with that? How to make printing? I think with the banking, this is not the restrictions. I think the banking, I told you, as DSSD is the way to without internet to do banking. UPI and other things are requiring the internet connections. The way the evaluations is happening on the internet side, it is supporting the banking also. Otherwise also, if you go into the rural area, you will not find people buying recharge without having our smartphone uses. I may not be able to travel to the large part of the India, but I have specially taken care of the task of the eastern side of the India. I can share with you, you will be amazed and surprised the way the rural people are using these innovations and the way they are enjoying these facilities. I think they are the most one who are gaining out of it. The financial inclusion programs are giving so many things in the digital side that is helping rural to not only even transaction side, lending, deposits, advisory, the right perspective towards the various instruments are being introduced there, awareness is being built. Okay, so is there any possibility of the victims money transferred through online transaction by online bank fraudsters? I'll come on to that, the risk part of the digital banking. Would like to answer your questions in this. I'm trying to answer those questions which are relevant right now till what we have discussed. So, Mr. Anonymous, wanting to know, India has also taken up a lot of initiative like Digital India campaigns, and we can see the impact. But there is a slow growth of digital banking in rural areas in compared to urban areas. To be frank with you and being candid with you, this is how the India is always behaving. The first adaptations happens at urban area. The second adaptations happened on the rural side. I think that is at some point of time, it is right also. Till the time it is timed and tested, not many who are not aware with the risk attached should be introduced to that. But I am not into the opinion that the rural should be given a last preference. Digital is actually, if you see, it is clubbing, it is actually filling up the gap, because when it gets introduced up to the last end, not into the urban area. You can see the kind of services which was available in Bombay in 90s, in 2000s, or maybe in 2010, between 2000 to 2010, was never even think or thought about in the rural area. But today, in the rural side, in some of the places, the kind of facilities and transactions they use, especially in the agri economy and agri-related fintech revolutions, you will be amazed that even urban guys don't even think about that this is possible. I have few fintech friends in the agriculture side. The kind of innovation they are providing and they are doing on the agri economy side, you will be amazed to know that the transaction possibility is not being used in even urban side up to that intensity and the up to that intensity. So Amul has a very, very interesting questions with all of you. That he want to know that when use of digital banking, whole control won't be with banks, so that the customer can be safe. I think the bank's responsibility is providing you the safeguardness. It is major responsibility to follow the regulatory rules. The fintech responsibilities and the new innovative technology backgrounds and the solutions are responsible to give you a user-friendly environment, seamless executions. But the vaulting part will remain with the banks, and that is important and critical considering the high regulation environment in the banking industry. How far is the banking is inclusive of all sector for the society and customers? I think the banking is always inclusive. If the banking industry is not doing well, I'm 100% sure it is going to be impact to every part of the world, every part of the industry or individuals or so on. Similarly, if something is happening great and good in the banking industry, it is going to change the entire ecosystem, the way we think even about the economics or about the personal life. Okay, Venkat wants to know, there is a huge disruptions from the fintech, which we have discussed, even in the past of serious challenges to the conventional banking. Is this, in this context, whether the interest of priority sector would be protected? I think it would be given a more priority than what it used to be. In the traditional banking, this disappears over the period of time. That is most unlikely scenario when the traditional banking will be disappears. As I discussed with you, that the banking is not going with the phase or generations. Whatever you have introduced as Michael today also exists. It is now a 50-year-old thing, thought process of the 50-year-old. Today it exists. Today it exists and today it works. It is not going to be completely abolished. It is, yes, it is going to be obsolete in terms of the efficiency, in terms of the customer convenience perspective on things. I think the digital scenario will enable branch banking, will enable the transactions, loan mechanisms. These are the enablers for banking. Banking per se will not be abolished. Banking will evolve, not be abolished. Let me go into, let me take it to some DigiLocker related activities. Is the DigiLocker really safe? Yes, definitely it is safe. It is as safe as you are at home today. Sometime in rural area, we face the OTP issues. Ms. Sonali wants to know. OTP issues are technological advancements required from the telecom industry. The way they are growing, that is how the OTP issues are also very, very minimal. If you are experiencing OTP issue at the present scenario also, you have to really change your service provider. Because I seriously have, not to disappoint you, but I seriously have a low understanding that any, low information that any complaints are coming due to the OTP failures. Today, everything is working very fine in the OTP side. Okay, so in the digital process, because people want to know what is credit bureau, and how is going to be used for rural economy, and at the same time how the transactions of the purchase will be settled. Okay, how the digital process is digital loan process is going on. The digital loan process is very, very simple. Today you want to have money, you don't need to go to the bank to decide what type of loan I want to have. You have seen there's so many advisors available, robo advisors, virtual RMs, chatbot, or so on, so many things. Then why the bank should be approached on a physical footprint basis for loans? The customer request can be go through with all the channels which is open and available. Today's scenario, the problem here is the hypothecations and mortgage facilities with the property. The laws and the Indian system still not taken care of that. That part is still left for the persons to address physical manner, analyzing the legal chain of the transactions, analyzing the value of those transactions are still not there. On a valuation part, yes, there are definitely, there are so many evaluations are happening. Today, I don't need a valuation for somebody to visit your place and then to decide this. There are so much of algorithms, data, and machine intelligence is available. You give us the address, you give us the details, verifying that on the value side is possible. Legal side, it is still a little far. There are a lot of things are happening on the legal side for registration perspective, mortgage creation perspective from the government, which is possible on a certain states presently on an online basis, like in Maharashtra. So recent introductions of NOI, notice of intimations on the online process, has changed the mortgage process into the online process. The way the I see the digital loan presence is presently available for all portions of the unsecured loans, where your security is only your guarantee. Your mouthpiece has stated that I will pay. That is how the banks are working. So that's in that scenario, the Aadhaar-based KYCs can be verified. Once you apply, the Aadhaar-based KYCs can be applied. There are two parts. Let me introduce it into two portions. One is the existing base of the banks and existing customer of a particular bank. One is non-existing and completely new to bank customers. Existing customers, the banks has gone into proactive manner. They have gone into the credit bureau check. Credit bureau check is checking about your CIBIL scores, checking about your CRISIL scores and CRILIC scores. These are the bureaus which are maintaining your credit history, and they are sharing the data with banks for the requirement as and when requirement basis with your consent if you allow. This data can be checked from backend. A time was there when this used to take at least a 1 day time. I will hit the bureau check today and I will get the report tomorrow. Today it is on the frictions of seconds. So what bank is doing? The bank is doing for their customer benefit. They have a data. And as all of you know, the customer behavior is being tracked. The customer financial history is available. So banks are not sleeping with your data. Banks are putting it for AI engineers, machine intelligence, and so many things. They are creating an options for you basis your requirement and day-to-day behavior for the possibility of the loan. This is your income, expenses, savings, transaction behaviors, your purchasing behaviors, and so many things are getting clubbed at one place. And then the decision is getting arrived without you knowing it, even within a few seconds. The AI enables the banks that to generate data intelligence on the entire customer base, offer them what best possible loans and investments possibilities are there. That AI-based solutions are given and available on your channels, internet, online, mobile banking. You go and you see that the bank is offering you n number of things in a pre-approved fashion. You go, click, in a fractions of seconds, the amount will be credited in your account. If you don't want the credit to be happened, there is a possibility from which is based on the credit card mechanisms that the fund is available for utilizations or purchase or something. So today, if you want to have, if you are walking into the place, your fund needs, your need is there. In next 5 seconds or 10 seconds basis, you can have that fund in your account and you can do the transactions. This goes with the intelligence on the data. For the new internet, There is a good initiative by Government of India, which is called 49, PSB 49. In the 49 minutes, you can have a sanctions from the Government of India. Kotak Mahindra Bank has gone a little far behind us. We have created a document channel. So through the FinFort, a company which is a fintech for e-financials, which can access, basis your consent, all your track records of last 3 years' payments and your IT track records, your GST track records, and your so many things which you're doing with your consent in the fractions of minutes. In like 5 to 10 minutes, I will be able to prepare the entire financial analysis tool for you once you give us the permissions, and the offer can be made for the possibilities of loan. These 49 minutes has daily hits pre-COVID era. Unfortunately, the COVID has actually delayed and slowed down the all this process. Has reached to 7,000 per day hits. So there is, so in this particular environment itself, 7,000 loan was getting processed with the option that you can choose the bank, you can choose the institution which is best as far as your requirement per se. The entire system is depending on the digital locker in terms of the signing of the document and creating a depository of the documents. Once you sign these documents, the bank doesn't need your physical presence. Bank doesn't need your personal visit to the branch. The amount will be credited in your account. The amount will be yours within few hours. This process is still to reach on a second or minutes basis present. Let's move to investment side. What is happening on investments? I think in today's scenario, everybody knows that you can go for a mutual fund purchase and demat purchase online basis. You can create your portfolio. You can create your transaction, 3-in-1 accounts, broking, demat, and banking transactions basis. All these are possible across the banking system. This is now widely used in urban areas. Definitely, it is reaching to the places of the rural. Fintech firms are working very, very hard. Recently, Paytm has introduced a SIP platform for less than 500 rupees transaction and creating a portfolio management for the rural India. The transaction size for SIP for Paytm is hardly 175 rupees per person, per investment. This is how this is getting scaled. But you will be surprised that this 175, the overall basis, the total corpus is even bigger than certain new entrant of mutual fund investment. So the process is simple in front of you. It is calculating of NAVs. It is digital calculating of your transactions. Today you want to purchase some stock. You don't need to go and create a fund. There was an era when you have to sign a DI slip, delivery instruction slip. You have to go for that signing, submitting at bank. All those is abolished. Nobody knows about DI slips now, present scenario. Everybody knows about the broking account connected to the bank account. You have money, you can purchase. You don't have money, your bank is supporting you to purchase for investment. It is a need to requirement or to the convenience. Everything is connected in this. The investments are completely digitalized now. This portion is far ahead than the portions of the loan sectors of banking industry. Payment banks, widely known. I have less to discuss because now this is like anybody's guess and everybody's knows. The only thing is that it is depending on UPI. UPI is depending on the virtual payment ID. So you cannot do a transaction unless you have created a virtual payment ID. UPI is the genesis of this. We have already discussed about UPIs and BIN. It creates a cash-free economy, financial inclusion. These are the two major perspectives of the payment banks which has been introduced. Till now, the bank was known for the all service possibilities. The time has came. The way we were discussing about the job requirement and the other part of this, the banks are changing the face. It is not required for a banker to be collecting, to be a collector of the money also, if he can perform the payment cycle well. there are so many regulations that the payment cycle can be managed by a payment bank. It is not a vaulter. It is not a traditional banker to keep your deposit safes. It is only to support your service for various kind of activities which you are doing. When you walk into the mall, these payment banks helps you a lot. When you walk into the on the high street area, these are the payment banks which helps you to achieve your satisfaction, not the normal bank. Normal bank has its own limitations, but the payment bank has no limitations. As we were discussing about what is going to happen for the rural economy, these are the ones who are taking the rural economy fast. Their penetrations are in rurals are faster than the urban areas. The acceptance and widely while presents are available in the rural area. Most popular thing, even in the rural side, and the most popular on in terms of the since the demonetization happened. With the payment bank, the new evolution is the smart byproducts. Today, you don't have to consider your bank as to provide your financial assistance or keep your deposits in the safe manner. The banks today gives you all possibilities what an e-commerce can offer. Today, the bank's challenge is not only to compete with the banks. The bank challenge is to compete with the Amazon, compete with Flipkart, compete with the all the e-commerce evaluation happening. How bank is evolving this? Today, if you go to Kotak Mahindra Bank site or you log in from the mobile and you wish to have a ticket booking of airline, you will be directed for ticket booking of airline from without changing anything in your login process, not directing for any other places. This is direct access possible from the bank. Hotel stay, or maybe this is a place where the bank has created, started coordinating with various APIs, fintechs, and the first genesis of open banking, which is the new era, which is recently introduced. It is not the bank who is going to provide you all best of the possibilities and services. It is the bank who will create a combination of services through utilization of the technology in a manner that the technology will enable you access of all industries through a one entry of the bank. So what are the benefits? Is it good? Somebody has asked question whether it is really beneficial. So okay, whether it is really beneficial for banks or customers, or it is just an evolution happening for intelligent people and technology. The perspective is clear. A bank gets the benefit of efficiencies. The bank gets the benefits of cost saving. The bank is getting integrated with IT infrastructures, enhanced revenue models. From this kind of tough scenario, when the margins are going down every year on day-to-day basis, creating an efficiency to build the margin is important. That's where the bank is creating, the bank is interested on the digital side. Lean channel and organization structures. The organization structures which were creating a lot of communication, huge workforce for a simple task is getting reduced to intelligent task and intelligent workforce. The customer gets the user-friendly experience, spectrums of the products, fast and secure processes, high quality interactions. The time has gone. जब आप एक आरएम के पास जाते थे और वो पूछता था सर आपको क्या चाहिए, दैट एरा इज फिनिश. इट इज दैट यू डोंट वॉक, इट इज द आरएम वॉकिंग टू यू सर, दीज आर द थिंग्स बेसिस योर एनालिसिस, दिस इज आवर एनालिसिस, डू यू थिंक सो इट इज इंटरेस्टेड इन मेकिंग सेंस फॉर यू, हैव यू ऑलरेडी परचेज्ड इट फ्रॉम समवेयर एल्स और यू आर स्टिल ओपन एंड यू आर लुकिंग टू सैटिस्फाई योर दिस नीड थ्रू एनी अदर वे. दैट इज हाउ दिस इंट्रैक्शन स्टार्टेड. नीड बेस्ड सर्विसेस, unnecessary undue disturbance are stopped. No call center calls, no consistent hitting on you for taking the loans or so many things. It is now a digital way when we realize that what is important for you and how it is going to impact your business. What does this mean for customers? Today, the sign is D-banking, not e-banking. So the customer, as we discussed, it is all about efficient customer service, time value. Today, what is the value? What is the money? Is time. So the time, error-free, this is the best and most critical. As we started, the experience is not joyful with the banks. The experience are till now is only satisfactory. The banks are moving from experience of satisfactory or an okay kind of environment. And they are moving towards the joyful experience. Banking services at any time, anywhere. The banks are in your pocket. You can carry your bank at anywhere, anytime. And you can have the facility, even if you require cash, non-cash, phone, loans, or requirement of purchase, or personal needs, or anything, whatever you think so. DIY, now the banks are not service for you. They are for do-it-yourself. Personalized service at customer convenience. I think all we have discussed this in a various perspective. I am moving a little faster. Powering service with the open banking, open API, open data, anytime, any medium expected to physical. This is changing the entire ecosystem from physical to digital. Digital banking is depending on the innovation and agility. It is not dependent on the your way, meticulous approach. It is depend on the agility and innovations. What is the AI role in the digital banking? The role, the entire world is now talking about data, and the data is the king. The person who owns the data is the king. That is where the AI works. The AI works to analyze the data, create an algorithms, create algorithm support for the customers, for bank, and predictive analysis are coming from the analytics. Predictive analysis is giving the best of the service. Financial intelligence, security perspective has been taken care. The predictive analysis is also supporting for the purpose of the customer, users, interactions, services. So this is how it helps and creates. What about the innovation and agility? If I talk about digital, digital is not a one-way discussion. It is a getting feedback from you. It is conduct surveys, market research, understand your customers, adopt new technologies, and consistent approach for building up the new innovative and meaningful development. Let me get into the future. Past is there, present we have discussed. How the future looks like. The future is all these channels which we have discussed and all these things are monologues. So bank has its own API. A bank will deliver its own way of products and everything. The customer has only one way. The bank is not going to be the owned by, bank customer is not going to be only owned by the bank. So third party will emerge. The third party is our fintech. Third parties are API providers who will ensure that the benefits are given to all customers through the data analysis, seamless incorporations of financial and pseudo financial services. What does it mean? It means for me, in a given example, if you want to buy a home, today if you reach to bank, he has no support and no service for deciding what home you want. But tomorrow when you will visit to the bank will not only provide the mortgage facility or home loan, the bank will give you which area, what is the benefit, and what are the pros and cons for that area which you are willing to decide is going to make the sense for you to decide about the purchase of mortgage. And then again touching you for interior decorator, and then again giving you the gas and electricity facilities on that. So the bank is going to have a full service organization, not only a transactions or deposit and lending organization. The point is this is the come when the needs will be satisfied by the bank, not only demands. This is the genesis of the scale on the Smart Boy product. Today, if you reach to bank, you can have n number of facilities and services to be addressed by the bank. Like the way you want to create. Today, the Kotak Mahindra Bank, if you go to the portal and you want to travel to abroad, Kotak Mahindra Bank will give you the all possible facilities, all possible channels by which you can book the hotel, travel tickets and all. So many things which is required. What you need is currency. What you need is a travel ticket. What you need is a hotel stay. All those arrangements with the choice of you. And the bank will give you the budgets related to that in a front manner. So what I mean to say is that when you want to decide that I want to go to abroad, you have a budget in plan. The budget is not even required to discuss with the Kotak bank. The budget is already decided basis the all AI and the machine learning which is running on your account, basis your incomes, basis your expenditures, basis past track records and other things. You can add on some flavors on that. The result will be as per your expectation. You need not to worry about an agent who will do a lot of activities with you, asking so many questions to you, and then deciding what is right to stay as a hotel in terms of the that standard. And the in terms of their cost. This is how the open banking will start servicing you. The next thing which is coming is the BaaS, the banking as a service. If you go with the PSD2 directive, this directive says that the monopoly on the data is going to be stopped. The data will be shared, definitely. It will be shared with the consent of the customers for the benefit of the customers on a restrictive platforms to create a value addition services and to create the best possible answers for individual perspective who understand, who will be understanding themselves by machine and intelligence that what is good for you, and it will continue coming to you. Okay, somebody asked that whether physical footprints will be moved. Yes, that is possible. The new generation of the bank is a without physical. The new and the latest generation is the neobank. Imagine a scenario when you are walking into a wall, walking into a mall without having a wallet in your pocket, without having any financial instrument in your pocket. The mall recognizes you. You are walking to a cloth stores for ready-made garments. You purchase some garments for you. You have taken that garment. You moved around. You have taken some grocery. You are moving all across the mall. And you are not putting up and being stopped at any cash counter. This is the scenario which new bank will bring up. Tomorrow, when you will walk into the mall, you don't need to think about what is there available in my pocket. The bank knows how much is available, how much can be lent, whether this need is can be fulfilled by the borrowing or by the deposits. This all intelligence is attached with the fintech revolutions. The fintech will give you, when you are walking out from mall, you are not being even interrupted by any billing counter in the entire journey. You go, you walk, you roam around, you enjoy this entire shopping experience, you move out without even thinking about the payment and the process of payment and the repayment of the process or the expense credibilities. This is how the new banks will go. New banks are agile versions of the traditional old-fashioned banks. This will change the banking industry in totality. The bank, the way you see, is going to be changed. Kotak Mahindra Bank has given 811 a new bank, where you open current account without even interacting anybody in the bank, without even knowing whether the branch is there. Let's come for the conclusion side, where what are the challenges which is there. So I have many questions in the challenges side. The biggest challenge is that whether it will be brick, either or, as per my understanding, it will be brick and not either or. Home alone or home safe. Digital banking platforms are safe. Cloud-based are the safe. They are as safe as you want to open it. If tomorrow you want to open your home door for someone, that risk is with you. Whether that guy is trustworthy, whether that guy is as good who should be allowed to enter, the same activity you have to do with the digital banking platform. So there is a responsibility of users. The responsibility is of user to ensure the secret questions, secret details about you, up to you. If you're opening it up to someone, you're opening up the door of home for theft to enter. The biggest challenge right now is the low customer user base. The banks want to change the entire ecosystem, but they need a base. The base can change the ecosystem. Otherwise, this is no use of changing the physical base. Awareness and education, the most of the fraud happens because of the non-awareness. A call comes from someone from some place and he try to lure you for so many offers and you open up without knowing that this is always not allowed from banking. And that becomes a fraud approach. And there's so many people are losing money for that. The biggest challenge which is right now in Government of India's hand is we all know, poor law. You have seen a film which is clearly telling you that one place on Jharkhand is exposed for having hundreds of people doing these kind of fraud activity. What is happening? What is the law? And what is the course of action being taken by the law? One side, it is really difficult to catch these kind of people. That technology is intelligence. The technology, the fraudsters are even intelligent than the technology. They are breaking the doors. The only way to look forward is to keep working, keep making more value, more systems, keep creating more walls to avoid these fraudsters and to get into a best possible customer value service. This is all from my side. I would love to get into a conclusion. As I told you, in the conclusion, I think we are already running late and the time is running ahead than what we are supposed to be there. I'll take some few questions if Professor Saab is allowing me. Accordingly, I'll see it. The question is from Amu Padma, is if hikers hike the account, the bank should call the customer and send a message. I think that is how the people are working on. If the hikers is not given a due personal information, there are many hike attempts are getting prevented by the bank's proactive approach and creating more walls for the new development happening on the technology and the fraudster side also. Somebody want to know what is Demat account? Demat account is a place where you actually keep your all shares into a dematerialistic form. This is for vaulting of your Demat shares holdings in various companies. So somebody is interested, sir, will you provide the PPT to us? It is now a Mizoram University's asset. You can be in touch with them. Okay, somebody wants to know how private bank controls NPA. NPA management is not about digital this, but only just to tell you, NPA is your ignorance on your lending and realizing things. You can control, you cannot be zero on that. You can be cautious while giving the fund to the right person, knowing the AI is now supporting a lot. Machine intelligence is also supporting to control these things. And also the behavior patterns, trackings, and there are so many things are happening in the technology side, which helps the private banks, being a technology-driven bank, controlling NPAs better than the non-technology-driven. Somebody wants to know whether antivirus, anti-spyware, or things can control the cyber attacks. Yes, it can reduce the cyber attack possibilities. The biggest thing in the digital banking scenario is that now you can see the bankers are working from home. I'm working from home and discussing with you. So all the systems are working from home. The technology and the security systems has gone up to that it is not only secure at a particular department premises basis. It has not gone, it has gone into the security possibilities at a time.
Thank you very much, Mr. Amit Pandeji. It's an excellent presentation, and we are receiving a lot of positive feedback about your session. And what I liked about your presentation is, instead of taking up a question and answer session towards the end, normally that is the practice, You started picking up questions from the beginning, and while continuing your presentation, that is one innovation you adopted in a digital way. So, very wonderful, and actually have answered many questions. And we know, being a busy practitioner from a banking industry, it is not easy to spare time on a working day. But despite that, we have agreed to our request to be part of this kind of digital movement. And I should say at this moment that we have started a series of webinars as part of a webinar series right from the month of April. And maybe we have conducted around 150 webinars so far, more than 100 certainly, in divergent topics by involving people, academics, professors, and social thinkers from all over the country and beyond India also. And we must be very thankful to our Honorable Vice Chancellor, because he's the main architect and he's the man behind the curtain, maybe I should say behind the screen, right? And I request our Vice Chancellor to say a few words on this occasion before I propose a formal vote of thanks. Sir.
Thank you very much, Sri Pandeyji.
Thank you, sir.
For your excellent talk. I've been listening, but in the middle, I got disconnected some information. But I saw many questions being raised by many participants. Actually, one point I wanted to know, what about the reinvestment of bank deposits by the banks, you know, as mutual funds? And what about the reinvestment time, how it is going to be affected to the customer? So when they get lost, something reinvestment.
So your questions is more relevant towards the mutual fund industry. Banks doesn't do any reinvestments. Banks actually lend it to the MSME, corporates, individuals. All the deposit which we brought from various customers and institutions, we do lend it to the respective for the economic development through MSME, corporates, and individuals.
The bank actually may not be directly doing, but they are sponsoring the mutual fund wings, you know, separately by the bank themselves. No?
So there are two ways. Now this is a slightly misconfusion about that. The bank does not expose themselves for investments into the mutual fund schemes and other things. The banks is always a borrower in terms of the deposit takers and some. And the bank's lending is always on the corporates, MSME, individuals as the deal fits to. The banks are offering these services towards the mutual fund investments and mutual funds organizations. Banks also gives these so much of advisory and offer the mutual fund facilities. The mutual fund side, which you are worried about, that whether you are reinvesting in a right size segments or not, the transparency is maintained. The biggest problem right now is when the Fidelity, when the Franklin Templeton has lost its the deposits which they have created with the various corporates. That is
I got you are mentioning, you know, bank is also encouraging mutual fund organization to approach bank and to get loans. So that time when you give and when they get some kind of IP that they cannot sustain with the investment. So what is that bank is going to do that kind of cases? They are not in a position to pay, particularly with reference to the banks, private banks like yours, no? And what is the kind of situation you are going to face? Because it is one doubt always I get like this.
Yeah, I think on the present scenario, it is really very, very relevant also. The NPA level yesterday, day before yesterday, RBI governor has also announced that the banks and NPA will on a borrowing level now. Yes, sir. The thing which I'll tell you, the every bank has a different type of practices and different way to manage this kind of risk. This is a risk management which every bank has its own policy to manage it. The biggest thing which you can do is is to create, I'll connect with the digital side, is that that you create an intelligence within your systems, which is machine learning, standards, and also very, very sensitive in terms of the movement happening in the economy, as well as the personal behavior of the person whom you have landed, or the personal, or the company which you have given, the way they are moving on. It is too late. Once everything is collapsed, it is too late to address those things. It is important that you have a trigger system, that you address those concerns, knowing well in advance. Today, if you see, when I'm talking about that, how banks like us managing NPAs well, is that our intelligence to keep monitoring that account in close manner. Secondly, the intelligence to understand the business well. If today it is not that when he's started defaulting the EMI, then I come to know that this guy is going to default me and going to become an NPA. I will be triggered from my various analytics that this guy's business is not as normal when I have given the funding. One side which is most critical, in the AI side, I do so much of analysis that I don't fund for a weak infrastructures guy or weak individuals in terms of the volatility of the his income to repay that. The other side, the corporate should be analyzed, the basis, the agility of the business model which he is running with. That agility need to be checked on every alternative durations, which has to be decided basis the various type of the loans. That is how you can control the loans. Addressing the once the it is becoming an NPA is resolutions companies, resolutions guidance from RBI, insolvency laws are getting very, very effective. If you remember that the recent resolutions of SR, recent resolutions of Bhushan Steels, resolutions of your, there are so many which is going on also. If you see the even resolutions is an advanced stage in the Kingfisher case. These laws are supporting like anything, but there is an intelligence failure from the bank side when he did not realize that the Kingfisher is going to be fall on a one-day basis. That is the intelligence which gives the ability for a bank to manage the risk better. This is how the audits are now happening at the bank side, how intelligently you are monitoring the things. That is where if you see the banks are being overstressed by RBI. When RBI comes with so many policies and so many regulations, they are not coming into that saying that all defaulters, you go and give them, put them on the bar. They are coming very heavy on the bank that why did you recognize what is happening on the transaction and what is happening on your management side of the risk? Why didn't you able to check the risk before it is converting into practical and actualities in the world? And this is the way it is possible to reduce this. This is how I think so.
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you very much. I just wanted one question casually I asked.
Yeah. Most welcome. Thank you very much. I handle the MSME part and I do day-to-day basis I handle the NPAs and the issues in the NPAs. And most critical part is that we are being pushed in between the social costs and the social preservations for the people who are depositing money with us.
Very good. Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Thanks.
Thank you very much, sir. And today is July 28th and it is being celebrated as the World Conservation Day. And the purpose is to increase awareness about the best practices to protect our natural resources. And certainly this digital technology would help us to preserve and to conserve our natural resources. And as you said, India now has more rural internet users than urban ones. The low-cost data revolution and the government's digital push have made it more inclusive. So you through your interactive session, you have answered many questions and many challenges faced by our country, especially in terms of this digital revolution, like how to handle digital crime, digital security issues, and how to bridge the digital divide, and how to reach out the bottom of the pyramid. So these issues we have covered very well, and we will continue to have a dialogue and collaboration with you, sir, in our future academic endeavors also. And I'm very thankful to the participants also for their very active, questions and very thought-provoking questions posed to the speaker. And when you started your session with, I don't want to wait till the end, I would pick up the questions whenever it comes. Then, you know, we started getting many questions, many more questions than expected. So thank you very much, Pandeji, and for your time. And there are some questions people are asking. There would be another session at 1:30 today. It is on quality leadership for future business organizations. So those who have not yet registered, I request them to register themselves from our university website. And the speaker would be Mr. Shashikant Singh. He would speak on quality leadership for future business organizations. And he is a technical officer and assistant director in DRDO. So with this, once again, I thank all the people who have participated in this and also the speaker. And thank you very much.
Thank you. Thanks a lot, sir.